Hi friends, thank you for joining me. I'm glad all you guys are here. So far today, there has been 151 earthquakes there in the Canary Islands at the island of La Palma. 151, and there's still about 3 more hours to go to record the earthquakes for the last 24 hours. Here on IGN, it lists those earthquakes. All the ones with minus 17, those are the coordinates for La Palma. And it looks like the largest that I could find was a magnitude 3.9 right there. Using Google Earth, here's the location of that earthquake. It is on the eastern side of the rift. Very concerning, not only because of all the earthquakes that have been on that side of the rift system, but the depth of these earthquakes. They're still very deep, which shows that there is popping of the ground, cracking of the ground, trying to release that tremendous pressure that is in this caldera. There evidently is now lava tubes coming from the main cone and going out here to the ocean, feeding this plume of lava that's going out into the ocean. This one, this 3.9, was 38 kilometers in depth, and they measure all earthquakes from sea level. So that is 23.6 miles deep. That is a very deep earthquake. 14 kilometers. Remember, they're all the ones that say minus 17. That's La Palma. What else we got here? 14 kilometers, 13 kilometers, 11 kilometers. Yeah, that one looks like it was probably, well, this one here, 3.2, that was 35 kilometers in depth. So that would be 21.7 miles in depth. That one too was way on the east coast. Yeah, are you guys thinking what I'm thinking? From satellite images of La Palma, they have reported 1,154 buildings that have been damaged or destroyed there on the island. For sure, 1,046 have been destroyed, 108 partially damaged. This includes schools, factories, public buildings, hotels, homes, etc. Here is a current spectrogram for today. Like I said, the day's not over, and you can see some of these really brought up some magma. You can see all the earthquakes up here. 151 so far. Here's an image of one of the lava flows. This is from Twitter. It's from one of the scientists that was working there. Here's an image from Reuters of one of the recent eruptions. One of the vents threw out a lava bomb. This is that lava bomb that I talked about yesterday. It evidently was 1 kilometer from the vent that threw it out. And this is from one of the scientists working there too. Another image of one of the eruptions that occurred today. One of the scientists there also took a picture of the ash that had been deposited on the car. There was 2 centimeters of fresh ash laying on top of this car. I don't know how much the total thickness was, but 2 centimeters had been deposited since the night before. Sentinel 3 satellite view of the ash being deposited. Yeah, look how far out it's going. So you know which direction the wind is going. It's supposed to change tomorrow to be going inland and then possibly out towards the airport, which will mean air quality is going to get really bad tomorrow there on the island. Current uplift for the island. Now this is from the area of the volcano and volcanic eruption. Yeah, it goes up and down, up and down. And I told you about the 3 cities that no longer have water because the lava flow has melted the underground pipes. So we got 2 here, no water. And then another one way down south, no water. So they brought in these desalinization machines to provide water for the banana plantations. Baluda Shipping, through Cooperation Social Responsibility Humanitarian Transport Program, has offered to collaborate with the aid plan to move by sea and road 4 containers that include 2 portable desalinization plants designed to guarantee maintenance irrigation in the plantations, most of them banana trees affected by the volcanic eruption of Cumbre Vieja on La Palma. So these 4 machines will produce about 6,000 cubic meters per day of water. This page has been translated. The 4 containers provided by them, 2 40 feet and 2 20 feet, left the port of Las Palmas this morning from the port of Santa Cruz de Tenerife. And I'll show you where that's at. So they haven't gotten water yet, but they will get water. I don't know how long it's going to take for these containers to be shipped from this location right here, all the way over to La Palma, over here, to be set up and start pumping water. So I don't know how far these people have to go to get water. For right now, there's no water for the plantation. How are they getting water right now? Or are they just rationing what they have? So once the 4 container ships arrive, this is the area where they're going to set them up. Right there. It's going to take 10 to 15 days before they can allow the irrigation fields. Yeah, so they're probably looking at 2 weeks, maybe longer, of no water. It says here the only tube that until now allowed the irrigation of 600 hectares of banana trees on the coastline of Los Llanos has been rendered useless by the pressure of the volcano's runoff and by the high temperatures. Well, it melted the pipes is what happened. Another article about the eruptions and the flow of the lava. Now, this is all from today. The emission centers of the main crater and those located on the sides of the cone are still active. The construction of lava tubes, which favor drainage from the main emission center to the coast on the lava delta, continues its growth fed from various points exceeding 36 hectares. And they also said because of deformity and geochemical analysis, doesn't look like the volcano is going to end its process anytime soon. Regarding the fissure zone, so they do have this large fissure that is not emitting any lava, just gas. The environment of the soil temperature there is high. So just exactly where is this fissure zone? Does that indicate that the island is starting to break up, fall apart, slide? They are fissures that are not important in the sense that they do not have any emissions and are in the environment of the current active cone, he said. It is not possible to know the volume of lava in the cone since they cannot fly over it. As for air quality, the drop in parameters of the previous days, thanks to the influx of the trade winds, I showed you that with that satellite view. But in the coming days, a slight deterioration will take place that may affect the airport. I already told you that. Because of the direction of the winds right now, the gases is now, as of yesterday, actually, I think the day before, arrived at the Caribbean there in Puerto Rico. They evidently sent some of the emergency workers home. There is currently only 553 people working on the ground in the emergency devices after reducing the initial troops when those related to forest fires were withdrawn. Now, the main fissure eruption continues to show strong strombolian mechanism that produces pyroclastic deposits with a VEI estimate so far is a 2. I think they're going to get a lot bigger, especially with how deep these earthquakes are and how large they are. All right, so this crack, it says here, the fissure is about 100 meters to the northwest of the already inactive centers with emission of gases and high soil temperatures has been verified. 151 deep, large earthquakes, or maybe moderate, maybe volcanologists would consider them moderate. The largest that I saw was a magnitude 3.9, and they're not going to have water for another 2 weeks. So the emergency workers that were sent home, why don't they use them to gather up all the abandoned animals and livestock there? That's just my thought. So what are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you, my friends, for watching. Please stay safe. If you have any other information that I might have missed, please let me know. And I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.